Hello friends, welcome to our Tech Management Education channel. Today we are starting our another series of lecture on basic course on stock market and option trading. You know, during this lockdown period and COVID period, everybody is eyeing on how stock market is performing. So initially when COVID started and the market was very in a panic state, so there is a big downfall in our stock market. So everybody was very curious about investing in stock market because prices are very mouth-watering prices of many shares and other things. So everybody was, many people are panicked, that's why market, there was a great downfall in the market. But one section of the people started saying this is the right time for buying stocks and all these things. So I thought, let us understand what is stock market, how it performs, what are the tools or instruments available in the stock market. So one is share purchase and sell, another, there are various instruments to play with in stock market. There are various derivative products, like which are not exactly shares, but derived from share prices and all these things, and index prices. So similar one product is option. Option product, which is very lucrative and very, it's a very leveraged kind of product. So it is being traded in our Indian stock market, in US other stock markets as well. It is very old product. People are trading in options, but it is very very skillful people can only trade in option, because it is it is not a simple share price. The price of that option, it depends upon various factors like volatility and other things that we will discuss later. So let us begin our journey for learning stock market, and then later on we will progress to option trading. Okay. So what is stock market? Everybody knows it is coming every day in our television channels, on other media, Sensex report, day-to-day up and down report. Like today's report, Sensex is 37871, and today was a downfall, so downfall of 15 points. Similar, there is a Nifty. Nifty today closing price is 11132, so down of 29 minus 29 point, and like dollar and other things. There are many things being shown in stock market parameters. Okay, so what is stock? Stock is basically shares, like partnership. So one company wants to start a business of say 100 rupees. So 50 rupees promoter is engaging his own money, and 50 rupees taken from market. So he'll distribute shares of total value of 50 rupees to market, and people will buy shares initially, and those shares will be traded in the market. Anybody can buy and sell, and prices and other things will depend upon the performance of the company or future aspect, future growth. Like this. So if my company worth is rupees 100, so 50 is promoter contribution, and rupees 50 shares public. It may be public, it may be some financial institute, institution or buyers, or some FDI, some foreign institution buyer, anything. So there is a 50-50 percent partnership. So after profit and all these things, quarterly profit or yearly profit, so promoter or company will have 50% share of the profit, and rest of the profit may be distributed to shareholders as a dividend, or depending upon the company decisions, board of directors, they may engage this 50% profit to future activity or some capital expenditure. So company will grow, And likewise, if company grows, share price will grow. So all people, all market will closely monitor the financial record or database of each company. Quarter by quarter, what is the revenue growth or fall, what is the profit growth or fall, what is the turnover and all these things. There are various aspects, what is the other debt by equity ratio, or there are various, basically they will follow closely the balance sheet of a company, how company is slowly progressing, or there is a risk or downfall in a company. So all progressive company or the companies, those who have great future or some visibility of earning good profit, so share price will say initially, if the share is say rupees 10 rupees, so after so company, how the company bring shares, like initial public offering IPO, you might have observed in news and other things, this company is bringing IPO like that. So they will declare this many of share of this, some will 10 rupees or 1 rupee they are bringing to market, and this is the requirement of the fund for which they are bringing this IPO, for like setting some plan or repayment of some loan or any, it may be anything, like company had some is having some debt, so maybe 25% of this ownership they are distributing to shares to get money from market to repay the loan. So that is one aspect. Another aspect is building a plant or anything, or a new capex expenditure, any kind of things. So company may issue shares to through exchange and other things to public or some institution for raising money. So this is the basically in broad nutshell what is shares. So those company who are in stock exchanges listed and issued IPO and there is a share in market, so these are public limited companies, and those ownership fully with promoter, these are public limited companies, you might have observed. So there is a public limited and private limited companies. Okay, so all big multinationals, big companies, those who are in need of money, they can list in any stock exchange and they can raise some money. And like if a company after issuing shares, after some time it feels they have enough cash and they want to withdraw some shares from market, then they offer a buyback offer kind of thing. So you might have observed some software companies and some other companies, those companies are having good cash in their book. So time to time after declaring profit and all these things, they buy back some of their shares so that they can increase percentage holding of that company. So similar way, after it's not that a company has given shares, it cannot be redeemed. So they can also buy back, or sometimes company, they multiply the shares. Like one company, after certain time, there is a big jump in price, 2x, 10x jump in price. So it's very difficult for common people to buy and trade such a costly shares. So they think to multiply shares, and so that each share price will be reduced. Like if share is costing 10,000 rupees, so they will do they will split the shares in with 10x. Then each share will cost 1,000 rupees. Then anybody can purchase and like that trade. So this is various aspects of share pricing and share quantity, how much they will be there, and time to time or splitting of the share. Okay, so these are various aspects of stock exchange. And India, there are basically two major stock exchanges. One is NSE and another is BSE, Bombay Stock Exchange, and the National Stock Exchange. Earlier it was BSE in ancient time, means old time. And later on, NSE started. So these are major stock exchanges in India. So what are I'll talk about some world best stock exchanges and what are the when they open every day. Okay. So if you talk about Asia, in Asia there are major stock exchanges in the world like USA Dow Jones and Nasdaq. Then in Asia, Nikkei is in Japan, Hang Seng is in Hong Kong, Shanghai China, NSE BSE in India. There are other countries like Indonesia, Malaysia, every country has their own stock exchange, but these are major in Asia. In Europe, FTSE 100 is in the UK, London, and DAX is in Germany, and CAC 40 is in France. Okay, so these are major European stock exchanges. There are others in every country has their own stock exchanges. In USA, Dow Jones and S&P 500, these are popular stock exchanges, and Nasdaq is there. Okay, so if you talk about timing, there is a time for opening and closing of stock exchanges. Like in India, stock exchanges, NSE, BSE, there starts at 9:15 a.m. and closes at 3:30 p.m. Okay, so this is the time for trading stocks. Anyway, there is another section of market commodity that you can trade after that also. But this is the timing of NSE, BSE. Nikkei starts at 7 a.m. morning, Hang Seng 6:45 a.m. then Shanghai around 7 a.m. Okay, morning time because there is time, they are ahead of us, around 2 hour ahead of us, 2.5 hour. European market, they opens at 12:30 with Germany, and then UK at 1:30. So up to 2:30, all markets of European, they get open. Okay, so this is the time for European market. And USA, they start at around 7 p.m. Okay, so initially how today's day will be by stock exchange fluctuation if you closely monitor. So people after getting up in the morning, they start looking Nikkei, Hang Seng, Shanghai, how they are performing. Then Indian markets, then European markets, USA market. So this is a close cycle, because nowadays it's not that if this is rising, this will fall or this will. Everybody is linked, because there are cross-linked companies and various associated companies. So how one means companies or some economical situation, if Asia is down for some serious news or some good news, then obvious this will affect the Indian market, European market, US market. If USA is up, then next morning Asia will be up. It's a normal phenomenon, but opposite also can be possible. So this is the normal, that each market is affecting other market. In morning, like in Indian markets, there's people closely monitor how Asia is performing, Nikkei and all these things. Then at around 12:30, there is a change in all pricing depending upon the European market opening. Okay, so this is the stock market. There is a big stock exchanges. And all companies, big, small companies, they are listed down. Many new companies are coming. Many new companies, they sometimes withdraw from stock exchange with some predefined market value they offer. If after a certain time they feel that they don't want market, they have sufficient funding, or they don't want market valuation, or they are not depending on market borrowing or public borrowing, then they can withdraw from stock market. They can again become public limited company. So this is also possible. Public limited to private limited, shifting, changeover is also possible. So everything is governed by some bodies there to monitor. Like in India, there is SEBI. Okay. So this is the stock market, and this is the world picture. So these are in money wise, volume wise, maximum trading or size of the market is bigger in USA, then Nikkei, then Shanghai, then India. Okay, and European markets are also very big. Okay, so this is the stock market, how it is being or shares are being traded. If you talk about Indian market, so Indian market, all companies most of the companies they are both listed in BSE, NSE, both stock exchanges they are listed. They are operated, and prices of each share is slightly almost similar in both the exchanges. If you see closely in share price of any company in BSE, NSE, it is in the similar kind of thing. So fluctuation, if Sensex is down, Nifty is also will be down like that. If Nifty up, Sensex will also be up, because similar companies are being traded in Sensex and Nifty. And apart from share price, we will also monitor in money exchange, USD, other euro and other, how it is related to rupees in conversion. So these are very important for tracking the, because if US dollar is down, then some shares will be up or down, because depending upon the profitability and other impact on those products or services. Okay, like for software, mostly people export. So if dollar is up, so they will gain in terms of dollar gain. So the software companies will be up. If US dollar is down, then Indian exporter companies will gain, like some those who are import heavily, like paint companies, they import oil as their base value. So these companies will be up. Okay, these are various aspects we will talk about later. So what are the bifurc and another thing, how these this value significance, these are some calculation is there based on Sensex 30 companies. Some calculation is there based on some 30 companies of these critical areas. All companies are divided into a sector, like some are from real estate and construction sector, some are from banking and finance sector, like any bank or like that. So banking companies are clubbed in banking or finance segment, real estate or some companies, construction companies, some auto car manufacturer, bike, scooter manufacturer, they are in auto segment, or some parts manufacturer also, like tire and auto parts, everything is in, it comes under auto, like cement manufacturing, all companies and cement, FMCG, like all FMCG products, soap, detergent, or any kind of cosmetics and any food, beverages will come, comes in FMCG in group, like retail is also there, like future retail and big bazaar kind of thing, all these things, media, some media company, all television networks and other things will come under these, infrastructure companies, metals, all steel, aluminium, zinc, all these companies will come under these metal, pharma, all drug manufacturers will come under these, all software companies will come under these, telecom, all telecom providers, mobile telecom providers, power, all power generation companies will come under these, sugar manufacturing, all companies come under these, oil and petrol, hotel industry, some big hotel chains and other things, they are also listed. Okay, so these are come under this. Then capital goods companies, like those who build plants and all these things, electrical products, mechanical, huge industries are there. And shipping and logistics, who provide logistic service and shipping service. So these are bifurcation of companies. And out of this, top 30 performing companies will figure out in Sensex 30. It is Sensex 30. So price of this Sensex and Nifty 50. In this 50 companies. So top 50 companies will come in Nifty 50. So there is a calculation for how to calculate these values and all these things. The 50 sometimes some company is not performing, it will go out of 50, and some new company performing well for this certain time, so it will up. So this 50 is varying, it's not fixed. Okay, based on the highest 50 performing companies, it's 50. Like highest good 30 performing companies will come under Sensex 30. So
like this in USA, maybe the highest 500 perfuming companies will come under like this, and here 40 big good companies, here 100 good. It's a kind of representation of the market. All sectors are representing the market. It's not that only banking companies. If suppose out of these sectors, you imagine 50 companies, performing companies are banking, but our governing body, they will not consider all 50 banking companies. There should be representation from all sectors. So maybe 10 banking companies will figure here. So 2 real estate, 2 auto, like that. Okay. If you go to any website, NSCBSC website or some broker website, there is a full chart of all segment and breakup of what are in real estate of 50 companies or 30 companies. What is the breakup of how many real estate companies are in 50? So how they are performing today, or what is the every details, you will find it in NSCBSC details website. Okay. What are the major companies, auto companies, which are in Nifty 50, in auto, cement. These are big names, and you can easily figure it out from website. So this is a basically a training session. So I will not recommend or name any company for these things. So it will be a general kind of training. Okay. So during my training course and for stock market and option, I will not name any particular company name or other things. So you will figure it out based on information given to various sources, available sources. Okay. So we have studied so far what is stock market, what are the world stock exchanges, and what is the opening time and all these things. And these are the breakups of companies. Okay. And how Nifty 50, Nifty 30 is there. So what is 50 means, 30 means, how price movement is there. Okay. Okay, so we'll talk about little about price variations and all these things, how it happens. You might have seen in television and other websites, like NSE. This is maybe 11,000. So today's start time is 9:15. Okay, so and closing time is 3:30. So if you divide this full time into sometimes like this is one is 12:30, then 1:30, 2:30. Okay. So this is basically opening time of European market or like that. Okay. So if you say some today's started here. So maybe here. So depending upon the 12:30 opening market, there will be certain jump or fall, okay, in the market, then jump, then fall on the market, then 2:30 some jump, fall. So finally, suppose market closes at say 10,900. Okay, this is the today's movement, like 9:30 opening. Then there is a steady flow, then sudden jump, then fall like that. So this is the opening price, this is the closing price. So similar way, we can monitor any stock exchange pricing in that. Okay. So if you every day observe our stock market, there is a jerk or jump kind of thing in 12:30, 1:30, 2:30. So these are very important points you should remember while if you are closely monitoring stock exchange or any kind of market. So there are some critical zones or like that. It's there. Okay. for understanding stock market, for stock market, it's not it will go like this. If it is market is good and news is good, everything is good, even though it is not a straight car, so it will have down, then up, then up, then down like this. So there will be a variation kind of thing, and finally it will be up or down. So it's not that if it is a good market, why there is a fall, intermediate fall, and there is a down. So it's like that. So this is the importance of timing and how market will move. There are few how to analyze stock market, and there is an important concept called candlestick chart or pattern. Candlestick, okay. All website, all brokers, they provide this kind of softwares for converting normal trend to candlestick chart kind of thing. What is candlestick chart? Candlestick chart will like this. Like this is a car. So candlestick chart will be like this, like this. So it's a another representation of a car. Okay, so it's a invented by some Japanese in long ago. So all stock market experts and other things, they follow candlestick chart to monitor car and how future prediction and all these things. So there is a scientific view of candlestick chart. Okay, like for uptrend, there are some green candles. Okay, some brown trend, there's a red candles kind of things. So what is candle? I will discuss. So there is a green candle and a red candle. So in green candle, this is the open. So we have in a stock or index, anything, we have a four parameters basically. Stock or index, anything, it can start here, close, if we talk about this green candle, it can start here, open, and it can go low, then again go high, high up to this point, then again come back to close point. Okay, like this, if we discuss, start here, start, then low, then like this. It will start here, go low, then go high, then come back to a upper high position. Okay. This is the gain. Okay. So this is a green candle, means there is a rise. Okay. And this is a red candle, means started here, okay, then gone high, then gone down up to this, then some recovery is there, some then it comes to close, okay. Like started here, gone high, then gone low, then some recovery is there. So this is a loss. Okay. So we denote with red with these things. So this is a candle. So similar way, if it is a 15 minute. You can divide block of any range, like 1 minute, 2 minute, 10 minute, 15 minute, 1 hour, 1 day, 1 week, 1 month, anything we can denote. Okay, so this is if it is a 15 minute candle, so this range of time is 15 minute. Okay, in 15 minute, what is my variation?